8 years gone by, we're still holding on. Save us tonight.
of broken dreams. Outside of the wasted and torn, a land of tears still remains. Soldiers of destiny calling.
So, with you guys around, all these requests asking me to watch this video, let's look at this, the Do video that I don't know how many messages I got, a lot of them. Just listen, see what it's about.
Oh, I love that Hello Kitty.
Oh, thank you. Well, can I play
I love
the
that Hello Kitty
that
guitar
I
too.
I kind of just started playing.
Yeah, definitely.
You'll definitely skip me though. Everybody skips me when I start playing.
No, shut up. Play.
Oh.
I actually can't really remember how it goes.
It's okay.
I
mean, don't worry.
You're that so is, encouraging.
That,
you're so nice.
That
okay.
is a guitar
like,
to get girls
started,
on.
Whenever
I need one of
like
those guitars.
Or
I needed one when I was young.
You think that's possible?
Did you do one before?
If you practice enough, you could actually get really good at it.
Oh, wait a minute. No, I remember how it goes.
Wow. Cool. He's playing the Steve Vai from Crossroads now. Is this trolling? Is it trolling girls online?
You played me for
when I was playing stuff like that,
something like that.
When I was young, playing stuff
you
like that, it didn't work for me at all. No girls cared about it. No girls cared about me playing solo. They said, "I want to hear Nirvana."
What do you mean?
What?
What?
Oh, that's the best guitar.
I
want a Hello Kitty. Hello
What's
Kitty.
Wrong with this?
If there's a Hello Kitty guitar for me, I'll play it on stream. We'll not play the whole Dragon Force album on Hello Kitty guitar if I have one.
Yeah, laugh at it. Laugh at my first guitar. I swear to God.
I like this guy. He's funny.
Oh, God. That was loud.
I'm sorry. That was for the last person.
Give me a heart attack.
Can you play something?
I could try.
Can you play something?
I just kind of started playing, so not really that
you
good.
You know Hot Cuff Buns?
Play some K-Mac solos. Actually. That's what
like,
you need to do.
Like...
Not everyone can play K-Mac solos.
Yeah. Thank you so much for that.
That's too.
You're
that's
welcome.
Too. That's
well, let
too
me
well
play
played
this
anyway.
Other nursery rhyme that I know. I'm probably gonna butcher this, so I'm sorry. I'm really nervous about it.
What the heck is so good? I butchered this. You made him play Hot Tub.
That is the best version I've ever seen played live.
That was really good.
Thank you.
That's the best version I've ever seen played live of that solo. And I've seen a lot of this solo played live in my life.
How are you dying?
Probably more than anyone else in the world have I seen that solo being played. Or actually playing it.
You want me to do this one, don't you? That's what you want. Yeah.
Oh my God. You know,
louder.
You know what's
my
the funniest thing about this?
Harder, my friend.
Is I definitely have not I have played guitar solos on stage.
Like your parents were murdered in front.
Where girls actually just carry on looking at the singer. It's like, I don't care about this. And he's able to turn it around. I need to take some lessons from the dude.
I can, yeah. I'm playing a...
Who knows the dude? Who is this guy?
Can I play what?
We can't see his face. I need some guitar lessons from him. Can we get some? Can you tell the dude I want some, not just guitar lessons, I want some live lesson from this guy.
Kill me. Kill me, please, God. All right, now, before this video gets too epic, I got a shout out today.
Right. No, I need some guitar lessons and live lesson from this guy how to be cool. He's able to play a Dragon Force solo and make girls smile. Look at the smile on those girls' face. That is classic. Everyone... message the dude. Tell him I want a live guitar lesson with him on stream. This is gonna end up on YouTube, so you guys better be nice. Like, be friendly. Don't be a prick. Otherwise, YouTube people are gonna think Twitch people are toxic. You know, it's like YouTube versus Twitch now. I've been asked every single day for the last how long? I don't know. To react to Tina S. Then you get the react to Ali Pata, and then react to Tina S. We done react to Cole Roland, so we have to do react to Tina S. Am I right? Is this how it's gonna be? So let me grab a guitar to make me feel good about. We're gonna do this, you know why? Because you wanna help Jason Becker. It's the right one. Signed by Metallica, Paul Stanley, Steve Vai, Sammy Hagar, Nuno Betancourt, Steve Lukather, Warren DeMartini. I signed this. Neely Brosh signed it. A bunch of people signed this. And this is going to go on the Jason Becker Reverb store. And what's the story on this? Well, you guys, we got 27 million views on this Dragon Force cover. I've seen it once. A long time ago. Have you guys seen it? Okay, who hasn't seen the Tina S Through the Fire and Flames cover? Who hasn't? Who hasn't? Yes, no. Okay. Well, let's find out. Most of you, it's kind of a mixed match, actually. Dragon Force covers are something that people, I believe, take some kind of pride in doing. Let's have a look. This is it. We are reacting to the Tina S Dragon Force cover. Finally, this was posted in March the 5th, 2015. So we were still cool back in 2015. Let's go.
Take one.
So, if you're wondering what's happening here is this. From what I know, from what I can understand, from what I would think she's done is they downloaded the tracks that people uploaded that they could extract it from Guitar Hero. From Guitar Hero 3 game. They extracted it off the game, the tracks, and they took the guitars out and just have the drums, the bass, the vocals from the stem tracks. And that's how they put the guitar in. So I think that's a good way to do it. If you're going to do a cover, I believe that's a good way to do it. If you got the stem tracks, you can mute the guitar and hopefully do some self-interpretation, right? Doing a cover is not about playing note to note, 100% one-to-one, because then you can't really be yourself too much. Hitting the chords and stuff like that. But I think you got to inject your own style of playing when it comes to it. Someone said, this sounds illegal. Technically, yes, it is illegal. But it's the internet. It's the internet. Lots of people do that. But I don't use that word because you are not on the 504 channel. I think, do it. Do it. I want to see you do it. If you guys got the stem track to any Dragon Force song, you can take the guitars out and jam to it, post it on the YouTube channel, do it. Just get on with it. Have some fun. What do you guys think? What's your score? There's an auto wire going there. An auto wire that I think is pick sensitive. Because of the way it was expressed, I feel like. And then she has a harmonizer. I think that's a good way to do it. So instead of using a backing track, what happens is this. You couldn't separate Sam's guitar and my guitar off the stem tracks of Guitar Hero. You know why I know that? Because I delivered those tracks. I delivered those tracks. I knew what they were. So when we delivered the stem tracks, what stem tracks are? A stereo mix of each instrument. When you did Guitar Hero 3, then let's say you send the drums with all the effects sound. You send the vocals with all the effects in it. The guitars and the bass. And the keyboards. You send all those instruments mixed with all its effects. So when you play all of them together at the same level, it's supposed to sound exactly like the album. So I think some people was talking about, I see on the chat here, about passion. We're going to talk about passion in a minute and feeling. How about that? And expression. Let's look at the solos and then we're going to talk about the expression, the passion and the feeling when it comes to this cover. Let's listen to this. But I know that's why she can't have the harmonized guitar of Sam or myself and learning one part, because the Sam tracks deliver Sam and my guitar at the same time when it comes to lead. So there's the rhythm guitar and the lead guitars. They were all mixed together at the same time. You couldn't separate out the harmonizer. You couldn't separate the harmony, so you have to use a harmonizer to play and take out all the guitars. All right, let's go. Oh shit. I didn't know how good she played that solo. Okay. Woo. Wow, okay. You know what? I'm gonna watch that again for 1 second. Wait a minute. Okay. That's how you're supposed to do it. Oh, fuck. Shit. Well, she killed it. Ah. Whew. Damn. Okay. Maybe this is... People saying this is the best cover Through the Fire and Flames. I guess maybe this really is now. I mean, this happened a long time ago, but I haven't looked at this. I saw it once back in 2015. I haven't, like, paid attention. Oh, cool. Another person covered Through the Fire and Flames. But shit. I thought she expressed that nicely done. And you can see she was getting into that solo. She's like, you know, she was like, at the beginning, she weren't like, she was like kind of vibing out like a kind of, what do you call it? Like a soul artist. But shredding the shit out of that guitar. Well, I know who to call if I don't want to play that song anymore. But that was a good. She stuck to the theme of the solo, and she really ripped those notes like the album. I saw her feeling when she went. She went slightly pushed the time on the last solo. I don't have it plugged in, which is stupid of me. I shouldn't play this guitar because I don't want to rub off Metallica or Paul Stanley's signature on this guitar. Since it's got to go on sale on the Jason Becker Reverb store for good cause. So I'm not going to play this thing. And then I'm going to rub off Steve Vai's signature. And I've got to go all around LA, get them to re-sign it again. Not doing this. So I thought that was sick. Woo! Woo! Rudo. Make the guitar noises. He's playing the lower octave wet. I was hoping she was gonna say wet at the end. Poof. But no comment. And she was chewing gum at the same time. It was like, I'm gonna chew gum just to show I'm a badass and look cool. I mean, that was an insane cover. And obviously this reaction video is going to get more views than the new Dragon Force video coming up, which is Troopers of the Stars, of course, because that's the way life is. What's life is about? what else could she improve on? Am I even qualified to say anything like that? Probably not, but I'm going to say it. She didn't have a fan blowing her hair around. One thing she was missing was the getting more animated and throwing her expression into the guitar, but maybe that's not his style, right? Not everyone have to be cringy like me and have a fan blowing and do those kind of thing for the solos. But I think a magic fan would be good. And I think this, all these about performing, right, takes time to develop on video and live. Expressing with your body animated, your face, your facial expression is part of the experience of for someone watching you play live. So I think all these things takes time to develop. You can't expect someone to be like doing that when they're 15 years old and go, yeah, well, why didn't you do that? And same with your hand techniques, your composition technique. Everything takes time to develop. I believe she was 15 when she did that. I mean, she did an amazing job. What can you say about that? When you play like that at 15, playing, you know, I would say, I'm quoting other people, one of the hardest power metal song or metal song for this kind of style, I think she did obviously amazingly well. The solo was even better than I thought it was. It's actually even better than I thought it was. The way she expressed those notes and accuracy, that was like, okay, wow. And here's a story. I did try to reach out to her the last time we were in France, in Paris. I tried to get her to come to the show just to hang out, and if she wanted to play with us on stage, we were very happy to have her, but I couldn't get hold of her. So hopefully, Tina S, if you can hear me, next time, if you want to come and hang out, just to say hi, you're welcome to do that at the Dragon Force show. If you want to just come and play, have a jam, we'd love to. And why not Twitch? Why not come on the Twitch and do this together? That'll be fun. Come to my Twitch channel, twitch.tv/Hermony. Go check it out. And here you go. I'm going to give you a YouTube cut right now. We're going to cut this for YouTube, right? Hey, YouTube, I hope you enjoy this music. Fuck, what am I talking about? Music video? No, music videos doesn't get any views. We do reaction videos. I don't care about music videos. Watch it once, like, blah, I'm just going to stream the rest of the time on Spotify or something like that. No one cares. All right, let's do this one take. Hey, I hope you enjoyed this reaction video. You guys been asking for me to react to Tina S forever, and I've done it now. So what's next? What should I react to next? Well, leave it in the comments. Hit the like button and all those stuff that you know cannot be bothered doing. But just do it anyway, because why not? We're on YouTube, so may as well do it. And yeah, thanks. Hi, this is Herman from Dragon Force.
And I'm Sam from Dragon Force.
Oh, welcome to Young Guitar DVD. We're going to play some stuff for you, some fun, some serious, a bit, you know, we're going to mess around a little bit. Hope you can get some information about playing and, you know, inspiration to make your own sound and, you know, go for the guitar playing. So, I hope you enjoy it.
Okay, well, I hope you enjoyed all that. Any of you young guitar players out there, if you, any advice we can give you is basically sit in your room all day, don't hang out with any of your mates, and basically practice all day long. Yeah. You might get as good as us.
Very funny, Sam. Very funny. I guess I think guitar playing very important to you know, enjoy it, right? Have a, you know, sense of humor about it, because you know the whole thing in the beginning, while you're playing, you start playing guitar, what's the fun part? It's important to be serious, to practice, and hope, you know, I think anything you listen to, you learn from, say, your favorite guitar players, from books or videos, you should twist it and make your own sound. You don't have to play exactly the way the other guitar players play it, because that's him, that's his sound. You're going to bring your own sound and follow a path that, you know, you make yourself. And, you know, what can I say? I hope you enjoy the DVD, and we have given you some ideas to, you know, inspire you to a direction that you want to follow and edit your own game. So next time, we're going to see you on stage, play it.
So this one particularly, I see messages all the time. You might have come across. Have you guys heard of someone called Alip Pata? I literally get so many messages about Alip Pata that I have to finally, I think today, look at what this is. It's an acoustic player, because people have been saying, hey, fingerstyle playing. So we're going to check it out. You know what? It's kind of cool to, I was just going to say highlight some talent. But obviously he kind of doesn't need my help, because he's got loads of views on his videos. He's got so many views on this video. He doesn't need my help. I'm not that important. I'm just some random guitar player. It's My Heart Will Go On. I guess someone else did that, My Heart Will Go On. Probably way better than Dragon Force did. I bet you this is like a million times better than our version. I'm gonna go, oh, that's how you're supposed to do it. Let's check out, by popular request on the internet, Alip Pata. I believe he's Indonesian, and Indonesia have so many talented musicians, by the way. They're like some of the best shredders in Asia from Indonesia. He's gonna be good. Let's look at this. You know, I love this guy already. He did one hand playing the chords, then he just played the recorder, and then most of his views are probably from his sexy feet holding his recorder. That's why he's sitting down. That is cool. He's holding his recorder with his foot. And that was way better than Dragon Force version already. He didn't butcher the song like we did. We literally butchered Celine Dion songs with no mercy. Look at that. He's holding his recorder with his feet. This is sick.
wish I was that good on acoustic guitar. This is the kind of music I can put at home in the background, relaxing, sitting in my garden. Key change. Was that it? Oh man. Dude, I was getting really into it. This guy's awesome. I gotta click like on that. Man. Okay. I was surprised actually. This guy's really good. Is I can put his songs kind of on a playlist and just like have it playing at home. This is a nice kind of channel you can relax on. I recommend it actually. He's good. What do you guys think? One take. No editing. He's just got one microphone on his guitar. Maybe he can open the Dragon Force show when we play in Indonesia. That would be like kind of a nice romantic warm up, calm everyone together, having fun, having a good time. I think that would be good. Oh, okay. That's something unusual to react to. We usually react to like nonsense and do silly things. That was a serious reaction.
Yeah.
Thank you so much. Should I call you the dude or should I call you Eric? What do you prefer?
You can call me whatever. You can call me Eric. It's
yeah?
fine.
Okay.
Yeah.
Eric, the dude, thank you so much for joining me on this Twitch stream. It's a pleasure to have you here. And, you know, you're another one of these amazing guitar players that I saw on YouTube. I thought, wow, man, this is absolutely awesome. And thank you so much for coming here to give me a guitar lesson like I originally asked for.
A guitar lesson. Okay. Yeah, all right. No, but believe me, the pleasure is all mine, man. Been a fan for a long time. But yeah, it's crazy. If I had told my 12-year-old self who was playing your song on Guitar Hero that I'd be jamming out with you on your live stream someday, he would have told me to shut the hell up. So yeah, it's crazy.
So in case you didn't know either, Eric is, I was just streaming, you know, usual, and everyone is shouting me these names to react to and watch.
Let's all chip in to buy the do ahead.
and what happened is I said, I do this live stream. People say, oh, react to this. I didn't know that people want me to react to stuff. And they said, the dude, and then I end up picking a video and you were just ripping these solos off and it was awesome. And you did Through the Fire and Flames. I went, whoa, that is awesome.
Yeah. You kind of broke the internet with that video. Everybody and their grandma was sending me that video. Like my IRL friends were like, yo, dude, have you seen this? And I was like, yeah, I've seen it, man. It blew my mind. It was crazy. So
yeah. Awesome. And here we are. We're going to play some guitars together in a little bit. So how long have you been playing the guitar?
Well, I'm 26 now, so I started when I was like 12, so about 14 years.
Mm-hmm. Cool. How has your journey been like? Has it been difficult or has it been how did you balance playing the guitar and doing other things? I know you're a big gamer as well. How do you put the two together?
Yeah, well, so originally I started out on like violin. That was like my first instrument. My mom forced me to do that in like fourth grade. And I absolutely hated it because it made me miss recess. So that was like my first exposure to music. But then when I was like 12 or so, my dad's played guitar for like his whole life. So he had a guitar laying around. And so I kind of just picked that up. He showed me some pointers for a little while, for maybe a year or so. And then everything else, I was kind of just self-taught, just learning off of, other friends that played or just from like YouTube videos and stuff. In terms of balancing it with like YouTube and like the guitar videos and the gaming videos, yeah, it's definitely like, I wish I could like clone myself, someone to make the gameplay videos and someone to like make the guitar videos, because it's kind of hard to balance both and like put out the same amount of both, because the guitar videos take a while to make. You know, you got to go on Omegle and get reactions from people and stuff, and that can take a while. So
have you come across a lot of weirdos or weird people on Omegle? I mean, it's a crazy place down
God.
There
have you ever been on Omegle, Mr. Herman?
No, not yet. But in the past, I have been on some old apps. And, you know, you end up, you know, seeing stuff that you don't want to see. You got any funny story that you can tell me about?
Is your stream PG? Can I tell these stories?
You can tell I think you can tell these stories.
Okay. Well, I mean, obviously, like, the main thing, anybody who spends any, like, reasonable amount of time on Omegle knows that there's a lot of dudes jacking it on Omegle. That's like the big number one thing that men like to do. But to be honest with you, that's kind of the most mild thing. I'm pretty callous to that. That doesn't even affect me anymore. I've seen it so much. You know, it gets really bad because there was this one time I was on Omegle for a good 6 hours, and you know it's probably time to get off Omegle when you recognize the guy's penis. That's when it's really bad. No, I've seen people doing stuff like, I've seen drugs and weird types of pornography, old men in like leather and chains and diapers and weird stuff. Yeah, that's kind of what happens when you just let anyone in the public on with like a webcam, just all access to a website. So, and that's not even the unrestricted site. There's like a worse section where it's like all that kind of stuff. So it's not a fun place to go a lot of times.
Okay. I mean, can you choose, you know, what to match with? Guitar, music, that kind of thing?
Yeah. You can, and that helps a lot. If you don't put any interest in, it's kind of like Russian roulette with, you know, you never know what you're gonna see. But a lot of times I'll put in, like, if I know I wanna play certain songs for people, like I wanna play like a song from Final Fantasy or something,
I'll type that in as an interest, and usually that, like, wards off a lot of the weirdos. But they still managed to get in there somehow. Like, I don't know why a guy would type in Final Fantasy and then have his pee-pee out. Whatever. I don't know what goes through people's minds, so...
Oh, man, you know, some people have to prove they have a big PP, you know? You know, I don't know.
It's usually pretty small, so.
How did that idea actually started for you, like, to troll people pretending you can't play the guitar with your Hello Kitty guitar?
Well, I bought the Hello Kitty guitar just to make, like, a meme video where I took my old Squire and I sprinkled, like, oo-woo dust on it. And, like, I shook the bag up and I pretended like I transformed it into a Hello Kitty guitar. And then everybody in the comments was like, okay, well, you got to use this on Omegle. And I was like, what can I do with this? And I was like, I don't know, maybe I'll just pretend to suck, and see if I can trick people. And ironically, anybody who actually owns a Hello Kitty guitar probably knows like what the hell they're doing. Cause it's like a collectible guitar that hasn't been like around for 10 years. Mm-hmm. So that's why it was like $700 or whatever for that piece of crap.
I've been trying to get that Hello Kitty guitar, but I cannot let myself pay $600 for a piece of crap. Do you know what I mean?
It's like, I know. It sounds so bad. To be honest, though, I think it might be one of my favorite guitars because I love the way the like the Stratocasters feel and the Squire feels. So I love playing it. It just sounds like crap. It's got like one single coil pickup in the back. But yeah, I definitely wrestled with that at first. I was like, is this worth $700 on Reverb? I don't know. Obviously, it paid off for me. So I don't know. You could maybe play it at a live show sometime. You know, play it through the Fire and the Flame solo on it like I did. You know.
Well, this
Eric the First gifted you a sub last week to Herman. Feel free to hang amongst the community on future streams.
Do you hear this crazy alerts?
Yeah, I'm hearing them back.
Yeah, I'm going to have to pause those alerts. By the way, everyone on chat, I'm sorry, I have to pause those sounds at the moment because otherwise, we might, you know.
Davey 504.
We don't speak
Davey
of that man here.
Davey 504.
Oh my God.
Yep, that's
Davey
why you pause alerts.
Davey 504.
Might want to skip that alert. There we go.
I let that in for a second just to remind myself what I got myself into. Alright. Well, let's try to do this song. Let's see if we can. Okay. If it's not good enough, we're gonna do two goes. How about that? Can we get two goes if we kind of screw it up? Chat, can we get...
Sure.
Yeah.
Chat, yeah, don't judge us too hard.
Yeah, pretend it's good even if we mess it up. We haven't really rehearsed this, but...
You hear that, right?
Yeah, let's do it.
Okay.
We did it.
Okay, yeah.
Yeah, that was okay. That was cool. It was like one take, no rehearsal at all, ever. I thought that was a good job. Yeah. Thank you. That was awesome.
Not bad, yeah.
From the sky. Under pale fading stars we sleep tonight, for our quest takes us far and so long. But with the rise of the sun in the far eastern skies, never bow down, for our kingdom come. We'll be right back.
want to watch it again. Yeah, the drum feel is good. She's tight on time. Look at that. Come on, come on, come on. I love that, the way that it does on the high end. Someone that finally smile. Oh, it's hard to see, you know, to find like drummer that smile, you know, that are like enjoying the moment. Most of the drummers that you can find around that are covering, they are like, you know, like so worried, you know. This is good. This is good. Smile. Yeah. Her face. I love her attitude. She's powerful. Look at that. Well, you know what? Most of the time, I see her. I mean, you see, it makes me feel uncomfortable, you know, to see like the drummers that they are like afraid, scared of, you know, like doing mistakes. This girl, she's just playing. Look the way that she plays. Look at that. This is the best cover, one of the best, definitely. Yeah, this is my favorite, yeah. Apart from mine, but this is my favorite one. Look at that! Ah! That's cool.
Definitely my favorite.
Broken dreams outside of the wasted and torn, a land of